going back to old Tommy, he's a rum old cuss. He was a turnip hoeing one day out in the field, right close to the road, and of course he got the end of the row and he was having a bit of a breather, or leaning on the hoe handle, and chap in a posh car stopped just opposite him. He said, "Hey, Tommy," he said, "where did this road go to?" Old Tommy said, "It don't go nowhere as far as I know." He said, "I've been here nigh on 70 year, and I ain't knowed him of yet." And he said, "Oh, you danged old fool, of course he must lead somewhere." He said, "I want to get to Broadway." Old Tommy said, "How does he know my name was Tommy?" "Oh," he said, "I guessed it, huh?" He said, "He guessed the way to Broadway then." Old Tommy, he had a boy working for him, George his name was. He used to live in the house, see. He'd been there quite a while. He asked old Tommy one night after tea if he could borrow a lantern. And Tommy said, "Oh, I think so." He said, "What's he want a lantern for?" He said, "He wants to go courting." Old Tommy said, "Lantern to go courting?" He said, "I never had a lantern in my time." The old boy said, "I thought he didn't, Mr. Smith. Look what he's got out on." So he was such a commotion one Sunday morning, this was. Of course, the old boy only had to do a bit of work for breakfast the Sunday morning, and a bit in the afternoon, and the time in between was his own sort of fashion. He'd been kicking a football about there, and old Tommy seen him with his football, didn't take much notice, and there was such a yelling and hullabaloo, and old Tommy went to see, and the old boy was stuck in the middle of the duck pond. He had to go and fetch a wagon rope to drag him out. Tommy heaved out onto the bank. He said, "You're a darn young fool," he said, "fancy getting in there?" And he gave him such a welter with the end of the rope. And the old boy got up and he was rubbing his sit me down. And he looked up at old Tommy and he looked across at the pond. He said, "Well, it didn't look very deep to me, Mr. Smith." He said, "It only comes halfway up thy ducks." All right, I'll sing you old Tommy's song about his granny's old armchair. Now me grandmother, she at the age of 83, one day in May was taken ill and died. And after she was dead, the will of course was read by a lawyer as they all stood by his side. To me brother it was found she had left £100. To me sister the same I do declare. But when it came to me, the lawyer said, "I see she has left you the old armchair." How they tittered, how they chaffed, how my brother and my sister laughed. When they heard the lawyer declare, "Granny died and left me her old armchair." Though I thought it wasn't fair, I said I didn't care. I picked it up and took the chair away. And my brother laughed and said, "As I put it on me head, you will find it coming useful, John, some day. When you settle down in life with a girl to be your wife, when work is done to roam, you'll never care. When you had your tea, you can take her on your knee and be seated in the old armchair." How they tittered, how they chaffed, how my brother and my sister laughed. When they heard the lawyer declare, "Granny died and left me her old armchair." Now in a year or two, my brother's words came true, for you see, I settled down in married life. I fussed the girl did court, and then the ring I bought took her to church, and then she was me wife. Now the old girl and me, we're as happy as can be, and far from home to roam, we never care. When the work is through, believe me, you will be seated in the old armchair. How they tittered, how they chaffed, how my brother and my sister laughed. When they heard the lawyer declare, Granny died and left me her old armchair. Now one night when sit like this, we got in quite a fix, for the seat fell out upon the floor. And imagine our surprise when we saw before our eyes a lot of notes, £1,000 or more. When me brother heard of this, he rushed to tell his sis. They were so upset, they rarely tore their hair. But I only laughed at them, and I said unto him, Jim, doesn't swish thee'st had the old armchair. How they tittered, how they chaffed, how me brother and me sister laughed, when they heard the lawyer declare, Granny died and left me the old armchair.